गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सेकंड वीडियो फॉर द चैप्टर द हैप्पी प्रिंस रिटन बाय ऑस्कर वाइल्ड फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 9। वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सो फार अबाउट हाउ द बर्ड स्टॉप्ड विद द हैप्पी प्रिंस, स्टेड विद द हैप्पी प्रिंस एंड डिसाइडेड टू हेल्प हिम आउट इन हेल्पिंग द पुअर एंड द नीडी। सो ही हैड आस्क्ड फॉर अनदर रूबी, ही सेड इफ यू हैव अनदर रूबी आई विल गो एंड गिव इट टू द प्लेराइट। He said, "No, son, I don't have another ruby. I was just one ruby that I gave away. Now I have these sapphires in my eyes. These were brought thousands of years ago from India. You pluck out one of my eyes and give it to the playwright." The bird was obviously hesitant. How could he pluck out the eyes of the prince? But the prince said, "I'm ordering you to do so. You have to do it. There is no other way out." As a result, he took one of the eye of the prince and flew towards the playwright. In the garret there was a hole. He went inside the garret through the hole, placed the sapphire near the wilted flowers. The playwright had already fallen asleep out of weakness and hunger. He just put it on the table and flew away. There were some wilted flowers on the table. He put it next to them. When the playwright woke up, he was amazed to see the sapphire, and he thought, he had no idea who had given it to him. He thought it must be some of his fans who appreciate his work. They might have given it to him. That was his idea. The bird flew back to the happy prince and said, "Now, If I have your permission to leave, I have to go to Egypt, be with my friends, and it is getting colder, and cold is not good for birds." The prince said, "Oh, beloved little bird, I see a little, I also, the miseries of this town refuse to end. I see a match girl now, a little match girl, who has bare feet, who doesn't have a cap to keep herself warm in this cold, is out there to sell her matchsticks, and she somehow has managed to drop all the matchsticks in a gutter. Now she is scared. If she returns home without money, she would be punished by her father. I'll get beating from her, from him." And that was making prince sad. All her mastics had fallen into the gutter and she was crying badly. The prince wanted to help her too. He said, "You have given a sapphire, you have given a ruby. Now what do you have to give to that magical girl? My second eye. I have run the sapphire in my other eye. You take that one and go give it to the magical girl." The bird would refuse to comply with the prince's order. He said, "If I take out your eye, this is the last eye you have. And if I take it out, you will become blind. And you won't be able to see. How can I do that? Please, don't ask me to do any such things. Which is not right." But the prince wouldn't listen. And the bird had to carry the sapphire. He flew across the girl in a very quick position and dropped the ruby sapphire in her hands and disappeared. Now the girl suddenly became very happy. She knew she would not be beaten by her father anymore. But the bird on that day decided, since the princess had turned blind, he would not leave the prince. He would stay with the prince and he would tell what he saw. From then on, the bird always stayed close to the prince and told him stories of the various parts of the world that the bird had visited in his lifetime. Birds keep migrating from one place to another. That's why they were telling him tales of lots of things. But the prince did not seem interested. He said, "The grief of human beings is supreme, and one should always consider about the grief that the people are suffering and try to help them. Stories of the wonders of the world don't interest me anymore. They interested me when I was alive. Now I want to help people out of their miseries." requested the bird to fly around the city and tell him what did he see. The bird flew around and saw the rich making merry while the poor were sitting outside their doors waiting for them to help them. He saw young children shivering in the cold with blank faces. Right. And the fourth thing he saw was two brothers under a bridge who were trying to keep warm by holding on to each other. But the guard scared them away, chased them away in the rain. Didn't allow them to sit under the bridge. The prince was saddened when he listened to that. He said, I think gold makes people very happy. Scrape out all the gold that is covering my body and distribute it among the poor children. They would be happy. The bird did exactly that. He scraped out little pieces of gold that was on the king and one by one distributed it among the children, and children were very happy because they had some money now, and the poor were also happy because they could now afford buying some food. Their misery of hunger was over. The gold would last sufficiently long. Now the princess statue looked very ugly, and cold had arrived in full swing. The bird found it difficult to survive. He survived on the little pieces of breadcrumbs, the grains of breadcrumbs that were lying outside the baker's shop. He ate that and he flapped his wings to keep himself warm. But the cold, the intensity of cold kept on increasing. Later, one fine day, the bird had a feeling that he would survive no more because of the cold. So what did he do? He flew and sat on the king's shoulders and said, Prince, I'm here to say goodbye. The prince said, I am happy that you have finally decided to go and stay with your friends in Egypt. The bird said, no, I'm not going to Egypt. I'm leaving this life. I can't survive this cold. I'm about to die. But before I die, he was a royal prince and that was a very ordinary bird. So he asked for the permission. If I am allowed to kiss you on your cheeks. The prince said, you have been my closest aide. You have been a concrete support for me for such a long time. And you have helped me meet the necessities of the needy people. So he sat on the prince's shoulder, he kissed his lips and he fell down on his shoulder. And then suddenly there was a sound of a crack. It was the laden heart of the prince that had broken. Now one fine day, the governor along with his advisors were taking a round when he saw the statue of Happy Prince and a dead bird lying at its feet. He said, the statue of the prince has become so ugly. It looks like a beggar. And what is that? That's a bird, dead bird near the feet. He said, pass an act. But the more his advisor said, even more in sycophancy. So his order was to pass a resolution that birds were not allowed to die in that place from then on. And the art professor said that since the statue had become ugly, there was no point in keeping it in the city center. So he ordered the statue to be brought down. The statue was brought down and melted in a furnace. The entire body melted, but the leaden heart, which was broken, didn't melt. And so what to do? They didn't understand. So they threw the leaden heart in the same dustbin where the body of the bird had been thrown away. Now the god sent his angels to earth to find two most precious things, and they came back with the dead bird and the laden heart of the prince. The god commanded that you have made very excellent choice. These are the two most precious things that you will find. From now on, in my garden of Eden, the bird would sing my praise. And
in my golden kingdom, the happy prince would be placed so that he could sing my grace.
So this was the story, the moral, the conclusion, the lessons, etc. we will be taking on in the next class. Till then, goodbye.